time to start buying ammo. In April 2013, I wrote a two-part article called Stop Buying Guns and Ammo. For those who have short memories, in 2013, during the Obama administration, federal agencies were purchasing what seemed like large quantities of ammunition. Citizens were buying guns and ammo in record numbers. As far as ammo, if it was lead covered in Cooper, even if they didn't have a gun that shot it, people bought it. The result was the realization of the age-old economic model of supply and demand. Ammo manufacturers were pumping out as much product as they could, and we were buying it. People started tracking the UPS trucks on when they made deliveries to their favorite sporting goods stores in the hope that they'd be first in line to acquire them. After writing my 2013 articles, I received several comments to the effects of, "I'll stop buying ammo when the government stops buying ammo." Well, the government is still buying ammo, and clearly you aren't. Now is the time to buy ammo, if you are smart, but how much ammo should you buy? When people have asked me this question, I've always told them to purchase, if one can afford it, 200 to 10,000 rounds of ammo, per caliber, they own. Now I don't suggest you buy 4,000 rounds of 30-30, or 300 Win Mag, but definitely for your everyday pistols and major defensive rifle, 223 5.56. I've always been a fan of 9mm and 223 5.56 for its universal popularity with military and law. 22LR is also good to have on hand, when it's not $30/round. It's a great little round for practice, or small game hunting. Bottom line, don't wait until the next major gun, ammo scare to stock up. Want to stock up on ammo but don't know where to go? I've got you covered. Federal Ammunition is currently offering insane rebates from now until December 31, 2017. AIM Surplus is a firm I buy ammo from often, and I'm paid in no way by them for recommending you go to them. Click on any of the calibers you desire to see what's available in federal and other manufacturers.